So, welcome to Meidum. We are south from the Giza Plateau. And when it comes to the pyramids in the south, this is the largest pyramid. Officially, Egyptologists assigned this pyramid to the last ruler of the 3rd and the 1st ruler of the 4th dynasty, Huni and his son Sneferu. Official story is that it was started with the last ruler of the 3rd dynasty and then finished by his son Sneferu. And according to official story, Sneferu was not happy with this pyramid. So he built another one in a Dahshur, a bent pyramid. And then he was not happy with the second pyramid. So he built the 3rd one, a beautiful red pyramid. These are the type of stories that Egyptologists are trying to sell to the world. Is it possible that during one lifetime, the reign of one pharaoh, 3 pyramids are built with the technology that they had available? It is simply impossible to build one pyramid, not to mention 3. As you can see, this is a huge construction feat. And it is in Egypt, so people should be proud of this. People should be looking for the real answers. Now, this pyramid today is a little bit over 70 meters. Originally, it was much higher. What we have today are basically 3 steps. Just 300 years back, researchers mentioned the existence of 5 steps. And it's probably originally 7-tier pyramid with 7 steps. So now you can imagine how much bigger was at the original time. Was it built as the step pyramid or as the true pyramid, or started as the step and then trying to be a true meaning that we have flat, smooth sides, like for example the Giza pyramids? We can speculate. Was it built in several times? Again, we can speculate. My opinion, they were built by more advanced civilization. This one belongs to the oldest and the most superior pyramids. So if they were built by more superior, it means they had the construction capabilities more advanced than we have. So instead of decades, it would take rather short period of time to build it. This is the pyramid which has perfect orientation to the cardinal points. So, if you take a compass, probably you have them on your smartphones, the compass clearly shows that this side here is perfectly oriented to the north. Behind us, it's south, the 3rd side, east and west. Again, very advanced knowledge of the perfect orientation. When it comes to the magnetic field, I just checked. Here we have about 43-44 nanotesla, which is ideal and very pleasant magnetic field. Good fields are anywhere between 20 and 70 nanotesla. This is 43. It's exactly in the middle, the most pleasant magnetic field. Now, when it comes to energetical aspect, as you know, the most important is the existence of the water. Now, we do have a water, we did have a flood in just a recent history, and of course before, so they were probably using the water canals for pyramid for its work. If we go back to the time, the site was enclosed. Now, of course, we had some structures made from the mud bricks, mastabas. Now we did have proof that some bodies were buried here, and we had another temple here, this time built from the superior materials, from the stone materials, from the limestone, and it seems that that was part of the original complex. I made a screening with the NEV camera, New Energy Vision camera, concluded that this pyramid is energetically active. So I will show you how we can see the energy fields coming from being horizontal, calm, and then being vertical here, meaning they are interacting with the photons because they are shooting the energy up.